Hey guys, so it has been really long since I've vlogged, so I'm really excited. I'm vlogging today because I'm taking some of the horses in and I'm putting their rugs on and taking photos of the rugs because Mackie very kindly sent me 4 new rugs. So I'm so excited about that because last year my rugs have been deteriorating, and last year they kind of just all bit the dust and I actually have no new rugs and I was going to have to buy some more, but Mackie had my back, so now I have all new rugs. And I'm going to bring Cal in and I'm going to clean him up, and I'm also going to lunge him, so I'm going to be putting that in this vlog. And also need to worm Dally and then put rugs on Welbeck and Fiona. So yeah, I'm going to be doing all that in this vlog, so I hope you enjoy it and keep watching, I guess. I've literally never said that. I sound like one of those beauty guru people, so yeah, okay. Bye-bye. So it snowed this morning, but it's all basically melted from, say, the grass. But the arena is quite snowy in the shade. So hopefully over there defrost a bit so I can lunge in a bit. So yeah. You gonna help me catch the horses? Hopper put his head in a bag of coal and now it's all black and we can't get it out. You're so silly. Yeah. He's so cute. So here's all the horses. The fields are quite wet. We've had a lot of rain lately and there's a lot of areas flooded, but luckily their fields aren't too bad, but it's still pretty mucky. Here is Cal, looking very angry. So here is Dirty Cal in all his glory. You are so scruffy. Yeah, he's super scruffy. So for those of you who don't know, Cal is 3.5 years old. I broke him last summer when he was 3, and he is actually a homebred, which is really exciting. He's our first homebred. So there's a few other videos of him on my channel if you want to have a look at those. And because he's only 3, he's a bit of an eejit, and that's why he's making weird noises. So yeah, I'm going to hose off his feet now because they're pretty muddy, and then I'm going to give him a brush. And his mane is awful, so I need to do something about that. So yeah. Well, this is not the worst mane you've ever seen in your life. Wow. Like, I haven't hacked at that with the scissors, believe it or not. It's just grown really badly. Anyway. So I've just cut his tail and I'm going to film it off camera because it's going to take me ages to do. And I'm going to use up all my battery if I do it, huh? He's so gross. Luckily the rug will cover up most of him. So it doesn't have to be too clean. Good boy. And the sun is kind of out a bit, so we should get some nice photos. So I am all finished grooming Cal. He looks a little bit better, I think. And he has his new rug on. Hello. And we got some photos of him in the rug. And he's very good at the trotting around the arena, kind of all fancy kind of photos, but not so good at the standing still photos. Welbeck is such a pro. If I just like stand her somewhere, she will just stay there until I go and get her again, but he just wants to explore
and he has a baby, so what do I expect? But it was still kind of frustrating that every time I stood in somewhere and then went to take the photo, he would just move immediately. So we did get it in the end, just about. Oh, he's so cute. But he was so good in the arena. Like, he was all flashy, this big flashy trot. Yeah, he looked really cool. So yeah, that is him. And now I'm going to tack him up and lunch him, so that should be fun. I'm not going to do too much, just kind of get him back into the swing of things. And yeah, so I'm going to go tack him up now. Hello, are you eating my hair? Stop. So disgusting. You do not like my new hair. No. So I thought I would do a bit of a voiceover just to explain what I'm doing with Cal when I'm lunging him. So I have these Vienna reins on. I have a whole video on lunging and why I use these, so I will link that in the description. I have them going to the side of the girth as opposed to the D-ring because he tends to have quite a natural high head carriage and I'm trying to encourage him to stretch down. He never really does that. And you can see he is just kind of going up with a pretty normal headset, like you would expect a horse to ride with, kind of, but I want him to really stretch down and work all his top line because you can see that he is quite weak over his top line, especially in front of the saddle there on his neck. I give him lots of walk breaks because he's quite lazy and he's not naturally like forward going, so I give him lots of walk, trot, because if you just keep trotting, he will just get slower and slower. I'd rather him do a few laps of a good forward trot than like loads and loads of laps of trot that is only kind of half-assed. So that's why I give him lots of walk breaks. So obviously then I change the rein. I try to do the same amount of time on each rein, so I did about 10 minutes on each rein this time. You can see that he really starts to realize what I want him to do and stretch down, which is so exciting to see. You can see that when he stretches his head down, he brings it up really quickly, and he doesn't stay down for too long, and that's just because he is young and he doesn't have very good balance yet. So when he feels like he's losing balance, he puts his head up to balance himself. Like, he just doesn't have the muscle necessary to trot around with his head low the whole time, and that's fine. He's still learning and he's still developing that muscle. So with time, he will definitely get a lot better. And I always find that they are usually better on the second rein that you do because they've had more time to relax and kind of realize what you want them to do. So that's why I alternate which rein I start with. So today I started on the left rein and then tomorrow I'll start on the right rein. So Cal is all done. I lunged him just for 10 minutes on each rein and then I did like two laps of canter on each rein. My lips are so cold, it's actually hard to speak. It's like really, really cold, guys. My phone keeps dying. I have to bring down my charger to the yard to keep charging it because it dies in the cold, so I've had to charge it loads of times. So yeah, Cal was great. He's just a little bit sweaty now, so I'm going to let him dry off and then stick on a rug and put him out. And then I'm going to feed them all out in the field, I think I'm going to do next. And yeah. I'm actually not going to be doing Fiona's rug today because I ran out of time and the lighting is pretty rubbish today. It's really like harsh and the photos look not great. So I'm going to take photos of her rug tomorrow. And yeah, so I just need to feed all the horses now. And that's it. So I'm going to untack this boyo first. He's just the best baby pony ever. Like, I actually can't get over how good he is. He's so chill. This is his like first day back into work. Yep, saddle on, bridle, no problem. Like, he was only broken for like a couple of weeks. Look at him, he's so cute! You're so cute! Oh, he's actually the cutest thing ever. Hey, Cal.
How nice is his packaging, though? Like, it's just so fancy. No? It's so cute. I like that purple one, it looks really nice and well back. very jealous of Cal. Well, Becky, you jealous? Well, Becky's going to get her rug on tomorrow, though. Aren't you, well, Beck? You are. Actually, I can probably put her in now and stick it on. Yeah, I'm going to do that.
I just have Welbeck in now to put on her rug because I got photos of it last weekend, but I didn't put it on because I was worried they weren't good enough, but no, they're okay. They're good photos because I didn't want to put her out with the rugs on and then the rugs got absolutely filthy and then I'd have to like wash them or something. And so yeah, she's gonna get her rug on now. I just have to give her a quick brush so I'm not putting the rug on this dirt, which is pretty intense, isn't it, Welbeck?
What are you doing? Hey, I'm back. You're a good girl.
Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna go and give her a brush now. I love how this is like the nicest colour rug ever, and I guarantee you tomorrow it's gonna be just brown, like with muck. And it's so sad because she looks so nice in it.
Don't you, Alec?
Yeah, so take a good long look because this is the last time you're going to see that rug looking this good. Isn't that right, Alec? I love all the reflective bits that are on, actually. I've never had a rug with like reflective bits. Pretty handy if they ever got out or if I'm looking for them in the field, they just shine a light and we'll just see their little reflective lights. Alright, Welbeck. So yeah, I'm going to put her out now. So she's going to be all happy that she has a rug also because she knows that she is the queen of the yard and it would just be terrible altogether if Cal had a rug and she didn't. So yeah, I'm going to go put her out now.
Now, two happy campers. Are you happy? Oh, they're so cute! Oh, Cal, he's flirting with Welbeck. Jack 100% does not need a rug. His winter coat is so thick. He stays nice and warm just by himself. Benefits of being a Connemara. Yeah, look, all the gang. Right, I'm gonna go get them their food now and feed them. Good girl, Welbeck. You look so pretty.
So all the horses are fed now. Here is Dali. This is Cal's half-brother and Fiona is down there. That's Cal's mother. So they're all fed now and that's the last two to be fed. So I'm going to end the vlog here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.